It's been 2 years since a California neighborhood was destroyed when a leaking natural gas pipeline exploded, killing 8 people. It's exactly that kind of gas leak, or even the small ones.
Someone with a driver's license gets into the vehicle, and they decide to go drive around town and survey for natural gas leaks.
That these cars are designed to find. This is a test leak to show what the car can detect, or rather, the entire kit stowed inside. Together, the anemometer to calculate wind speed and direction, GPS communication device, cavity ring down spectrometer in the back that analyzes the air sucked up underneath the front bumper.
Hole there and a hole here. A hole here.
Along with a proprietary software system, it can pick out one molecule of the stable isotopes of methane in the air just by driving by, even if the leak is underground. Picaro sent it out the idea in 2009 and now manufactures all of its sensitive equipment in Silicon Valley. This is the room where the delicate cavity ring down spectrometers are made.
So the air gets pulled in through these filters into the system, and then is circulated back out through here.
And this is where they're tested before being shipped out. Picaro has now spread its technology to 61 countries using managed service agreements to hook up utility companies with the sensitive equipment, all manufactured in California. Its CEO approached the utility company responsible for the San Bruno disaster, and it's now a customer. But he says that truthfully, that kind of incident could happen anywhere around the world. He's particularly concerned about the aging infrastructure in the U.S. and Europe.
And the problem is that the world's natural gas distribution infrastructure is literally full of holes. And those holes have to be found and fixed. And that's what our technology does. So this is not a problem that's related to any particular utility company in the world. Believe me, we know.
The mobile gas detectors save time because previously, utility company employees would have to manually walk to survey their lines for leaks. Best of all, their headquarters will get up-to-the-minute data about leaks.
With the systems that we have running right now in the United States, I could go online, or anybody else could, in the company that is running the instruments and see what is happening real time from thousands of miles away. So if you just think about enterprise efficiency, having that information, seeing what is happening as the data are being collected, and then being able to multiplex that to hundreds of people in an institution in real time is incredibly powerful.
And in a disaster situation, like an earthquake, the same technology can fly overhead and survey whole neighborhoods for leaks. In Silicon Valley, Carrie Davis, IDG News Service.